Hello and welcome to Body Bags. My name is James and I'm your Sunday night reviewer. And today I'll be bringing you another one of those in-car reviews. A bit of a hectic weekend. I'm moving house next week. So in the middle of doing a huge pack at the moment. So of course I've gone and packed all of my films without really thinking about that one too well. So I was thinking about something to review. Having a look through my letterbox, which is, by the way, james.cowx, if anyone wants to have a look at what I'm watching. And there's one I actually watched pretty much early last month, I think it was. And it was Cujo. I think in one of the Facebook groups somewhere, you know, all the Facebook groups that we're all in. There was a Stephen King conversation, and I was thinking about the films, the Stephen King adaptations, and I was like, Cujo, because there's also that, I think it was Eureka last year, early last year, that put out that rather nice box set of Cujo, and I was thinking of getting it, but then Cujo, it's always a film that I never like as much as I think I'm going to like it. I don't know what it is, but there's always problems that I have with it. If I think about it very quickly, I'm like, yeah, there's lots going on. Plenty to keep my appetite whetted. But then when I'm actually watching it, I'm like, well, it's just one of those where it just doesn't fully click with me. So I decided to give that one a watch again. So we all know the basic premise of Cujo. I'm not 100% sure where it is in America now, but we have this wealthy family, dad, mom, child. The dad's working away on projects a lot. I think he's working for an advertising firm or something like that. Yeah, it's something like that, and he's like, so he's working away a lot. Slight twist to the dynamic, the mum is having an affair. Kind of, that doesn't really ever link in really well. I mean, I'll come back to that in a little bit. But there's this other family, they're kind of out in the sticks a bit. Kind of redneck family. Again, mum, dad, and child, a little bit of an older boy, but they have a dog as well. I think it's the Saint Bernard, Cujo, and he gets bitten by a bat near the start of the film, or several bats, and I think that's an easy one to link to rabies, or people's idea of how you get rabies, so that kind of worked well. And then he slowly starts to degenerate. It's like the rabies takes hold of him. Then also this family, they're having loads of problems. Like I say, super redneck. It's like the dad is in control of everything, the mom has kind of no life sort of thing. But then she has a lottery win and he lets her go away for a while, and it's pretty obvious that she's probably never going to come back. She takes the son with her, but also within that he doesn't want her to go anywhere. Then he's like, right, he meets up, hooks up with one of his mates, and he's like, we're going to get blind drunk, we're going to visit some strip clubs and all this stuff. And so that goes on. So parallel to this, we have some more dynamic of what's going on with our main family. So she's got car problems, he's got car problems, he has his car sorted. That it's recommended that they go to this redneck family because pretty cheap with what he does, and he does a good job apparently. So that all happens. The dad has to go away again. He knows that there's something going on. There's a few scenes where it kind of transpires that there is the affair, but he has to go away for work. And then the mom goes and takes the car to get fixed at this redneck place out in the sticks. And she gets there, the car only just about gets her there. But then there's the rabid dog, and the rabid dog has already kind of gone through the dad and the dad's mate, and now he's kind of stalking his own home, his own territory, and now they're in his territory. So they're stuck in this broken down car with no one else there. See, this is late 70s, early 80s. No, I think it's early 80s, Cujo. So yeah, they're stuck in the car. No food, no water. Very, very, very hot day and hot time of year. And so they start to not do so well and trying to figure out how to escape. The car, the dog is constantly terrorizing them, trying to break through into the car. It's pretty interesting looking stuff at times. And you got the kid freaking out. I think the kid does actually a fantastic job in this film. Oh, the mum is Dee Wallace, by the way, so we know that she does a good job. So these two in the car, these are like really pretty good scenes, pretty claustrophobic scenes and intense. Well, the film carries on. Let's just kind of wrap this up. Not kind of give everything away. Let's kind of leave it there. We can kind of figure out how it goes. Whether she gets help, whether she doesn't, these sorts of things. So, how this film goes, like I said, I struggle with it. I obviously like Dee Wallace. I don't like her character. I don't really like any of the other characters in this film. There's no one to actually like, because they did Dee Wallace's character as someone that cheats. So you're not going to like her. The dad is a little bit spineless and doesn't do anything about the cheating. You've got the cheater himself. There's no one to really like in this film. How the whole cheating aspect of it kind of, I feel it damages the film. Now, I have Cujo the book sat on my shelf unread, which is really stupid. I should get down and have some reading time of some Stephen King, catch up. I've got quite a few of these books now that I've not read, so I need to kind of go through those, I think. But this dynamic, maybe it works on paper, but it doesn't work on the screen, I don't think. Or it's not fleshed out enough, and it's not integral enough, to the story to make it really link and be like a worthwhile component to the story. The element, it's not strong enough. So that, coupled with the characters that you don't really like, it kind of struggles. You're not really interested in anything else that's really going on in the film. It's all a little bit bland. The intensity is obviously the dog attack scenes with Cujo destroying this tiny little car. I'm not kind of what sure car it is, actually. One of these small Japanese ones, which I think was fairly popular in America during the late 70s, early 80s. But those scenes where he's trashing the car and they're kind of obviously scared, they look genuinely scared. Like I said, the kid does a great job, especially at one point where he's almost starting to fit because he's dehydrating, and how he screams and how he cries. Oh my god, this kid must be really screaming and really crying. I don't know if they really got someone smashing and banging the outside of the car, because this kid looks petrified. He really does. But, I mean, I think this was probably my favourite watch of the film, but if I had to break it down into a value, 6.5 out of 10, something like that. I've noticed that I rarely actually give films grades anymore, unless it's kind of like an end of the year thing. I'm trying to put the list together, and then I look at the top films, but generally speaking, it's just kind of, I rate them as I enjoyed it or I didn't enjoy it. And this was a kind of, it's an okay enjoy, it's not a bad film, but it's just lacking these elements. Everything feels a little bit loose, and I think when you lack in your characters for liking, wanting to like them, and you don't get that, that's always a big damaging aspect of any film. Anyway, that's me waffling on about Cujo. Hope you enjoyed the review, and I'll catch you guys next week when we have a slightly new tweak that we're doing. So we'll have our theme weeks that we have every month, but also for a small period of time, not for as long as it kind of carries on, every second week of the month we're going to focus on a label. So we have a look at a film that's released on a certain label, and then have a look at general other bits and pieces, whether we want to mention the packaging or any extras or the general release as a whole. So that's what we're doing, and next week we have Scream Factory coming up. So hope you guys enjoy that. Please leave comments on everyone's videos that if you like this idea or if you don't. So it like I said, for the foreseeable future, week one will be a general review. Week two will be one of these themed week where we focus on a release company. Week three will be general review, and week four will be our obviously theme weeks, so we have no idea what they are. We'll try and make those as interesting as possible. But anyway, hope you all have a great week. Catch you on Sunday, and tomorrow we have BDG reviews, but I think we're having Lonnie cover him because BDG is having a few issues with his camera. But anyway, guys, speak to you later. Bye bye.